kept you waiting, huh?
The preview that you are watching was none other than Kali Linux running under the Podman container. Podman is a container agent developed by Red Hat that can be used to manage containerized applications and services. Unlike other container engines like Docker, Podman does not require a daemon to be running in the background, which can improve security and simplify development. First of all, we need to fulfill the requirement that is very important to run Podman properly. And that requirement is none other than qemu. Podman will utilize qemu to manage its containers. Hello and welcome to Sam Archer YouTube channel. This is the demonstration of Podman. In this video, we will take a look at how to use Podman to create and manage containers on your local machine. First step is to install Podman on your machine. To check version of your Podman, use Podman version command. Now we are going to install Podman machine. Ignore the error. Now we are going to start Podman machine. As you can see, we are getting an error. To resolve this issue, we need to install the gvproxy. Just do a simple Google search of gvproxy and you will find a GitHub link. Go to releases section and download the gvproxy Linux. use chmod command to convert gvproxy into an executable file. Now we are going to move the gvproxy to the directory that we have created. Once we installed the gvproxy, our next step is to start the Podman machine. Now let's try to start the Podman machine. Podman machine is started successfully. You can use Podman machine stop command to stop the machine. For this test, let's pull the Kali Linux rolling image. You can actually see how many images you have installed by just using the Podman image list command. Now let's try to build a container. To make the Podman container, you can use this command. You can actually make as many containers as you want by using this command. As you can see, we are inside our Kali Linux container and we can use any Kali Linux command we want. First, now let's try to update our Kali Linux container. As you can see, our Kali Linux container is working properly. Let's install NeoFetch to see our Kali Linux configuration. Thank you. we have successfully tested our Kali Linux image file. You can use podman ps command to see how many containers you are running. To stop the container that you are using, you can use the podman stop command followed by the container id. Just use the same command and replace stop with start to start your container. To access the terminal mode of your container, just use the attach command followed by the container ID. Now we are going to remove our container. To remove the container, just use the podman rm command. Now let's check the containers. As you can see, we have successfully removed our container. Now let's try to remove the Kali Linux image file. As you can see, we have successfully deleted our Kali Linux image file. Those who watch my video till the end, I thank you all, and please leave a comment for feedback and show me some love by hitting a like button and subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching.